Welcome to all our viewers in Angel TV, and welcome especially to you, all the little children that are now watching this program of Granny's Telly. Now, we are going to learn something very special today. Do you know what that is? It's about being hidden in God. Does anybody know what is to be hidden in God? Well, then we are going to start with, before we do anything else, we start with
praying.
Yes. So we'll dedicate today to the Lord Jesus, and then we're going to read some scriptures, and after that we are going to do some
experiments.
Yes, very good, children. And with the experiments, we'll be able to understand the scriptures a little bit better. Is that exciting?
Yes.
Very good, children. Are you excited too? Okay. What do we do when we pray? Children?
Put our hands together and close your eyes.
Very good. And we get on our knees, right? That is right. Everybody's little heart be quiet now. And all the eyes closed. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord. You are such a good God. Thank you for being with us always, Lord, and always helping us to do the things that you want us to do, Lord. Thank you for your Spirit, Lord. And thank you, Lord Jesus, that you always walk before us and show us what is the best way for us. Lord, today you have given us a word for the little children to learn what is to be hidden in God. I pray therefore, Lord, that every heart be wide open, Lord, to receive your Spirit of wisdom and revelation, and their eyes and their ears be open, Lord, to understand, to listen very carefully to what your Spirit is saying, Lord. Prepare our hearts, Lord, that we may know you more and we may have a closer relationship with you, especially, Lord, for all the little children that are watching, Lord God. Let a revelation of Christ be deeply written in their minds and in their hearts. And we all say, Amen. Very good, little children. Very good to you too. You've done a good job. Now Grammy is going to sit again in her chair, right? Well, I have some papers here that especially came for this reason. Let's pretend that's you. Right? Can you imagine? Close your eyes. Close your eyes too. Can you imagine? Can you see the paper now? Let's open our eyes and have a look. Where's the paper now? Where is the paper? Naomi? Oh, well, it was hidden where? Inside? Yes?
Under your scarf?
Sure, that's right. So we pretend that this is you and this is God's presence. And you are hidden inside God. Shall we do another experiment?
Yes.
Okay, who will volunteer? I got one volunteer. I need one. Okay, Felicity, come here. Would you kneel down right here? Okay, everybody have a good look. Kneel down, please. That's a kneel down. Okay, everybody have a good look at Felicity, right? She there? Are you sure? Okay, everybody close their eyes. Not cheating. You close your eyes too. Did you look at Felicity? Very good. Now close your eyes. Everybody has their eyes closed?
Yes.
Okay, let's see what we can do. Don't open your eyes. Don't open your eyes. No opening. Anybody cheating? No watching. Okay. Okay, everybody can open their eyes. And now, where is Felicity? Anybody know? Do you know? Where's Felicity? Who do we choose? Gabrielle. Little Gabrielle. And the dead? There you are! So, cover her. That's right. So, just like that, you know, when we are hidden in God, let's say this is God, Naomi, thank you. That's good. When we have God covering us, are you watching? We can no longer see her. We see God. Can you imagine that?
Yes.
Very good. A clap for everybody. And a clap for Felicity who's helping us. Very good. Now, I have some scriptures for us to read. And who do you think we should choose? Okay, Gabriella, would you read the scriptures in Colossians chapter 3, verse 3?
For you have died and your life is hidden with the Messiah in God.
Very good. That was lovely reading of the scriptures. Did you hear what it was said? What does the scripture say? Shall we help the children? What did the scripture say? That we have?
Died.
We have died. Died to what? We really dead?
No.
We dead to the world. And we dead to sin. Right? It's like we were dead. We no longer are the one we used to be. When we come to Jesus, do we do the same thing we used to do?
No.
No. So it's like the other person. What happened to it? For you have died. Right? The old person have died. And now the new life is what? Very good. And your life is hidden in the Messiah? Have you asked the Lord Jesus to come into your life? To give you his life, you give him your life, and then your life is hidden in him. Now, anybody here has done that? Have you given your life to the Lord Jesus?
Yes.
Yes? Are you excited about it?
Yes.
Yes, that's right. So are you the same you used to be?
No.
Are you? No. Who are we now? We have a new life. And our new life is what?
Hidden.
That is right. Hidden in the Lord Jesus Christ. That was a good scripture to let us know that we are hidden in the Lord Jesus when we ask him to come into our life. Now, what do you reckon? Can we give him a little bit of our life and another little bit we keep to ourselves? That is right, Naomi. Why do you think we had to give all? Yes, Naomi?
So you can make it better and you can learn more.
That's right. Because if you give only a little bit, how much can he give you?
A little bit.
How much can he hide you?
A little bit.
So when danger comes, what happens? The devil can come and what? Oh. Right? So we give all of our life, right?
Yeah.
And then? His life covers. Yes. Very good, children. Did you see that? So have you given only a little bit or all of your life? We better give all of our life to the Lord Jesus so he can give us all of his life and keep us very secure and hidden from all dangers. Is that a good thing?
Yes,
that is a very good thing. I do have some experiments to show you. Are we ready?
Yes!
Let's get ready for experiment. Well, to do this experiment, you need a little container like this or just a plastic cup. You put a little bit of milk on it, and while I do that, quick, can you pass me your jars? We will do some with milk, and we will do some with water. Okay? Now, can you pass me your... Okay, that's what you want. Okay, put it close. Are you watching? You can put either milk or you can put water. Make sure that your cup or your little container has enough for some other things to float on it. So what we are going to do? We are going to pretend that this is the world. So what is your thing? The world. I better put my ball. I put some water in my ball. Okay? Oh. Okay. And this is the world. Now, the Word of God says something. So, we're going to explain what the Word of God says. It says that darkness will cover the world in the last days. Whoa. So it's going to be dark in the world. All right? Now, tell me, can we make it look dark?
Yes.
How are we going to make it look dark?
With the pebble.
Yes, you are so clever. Okay, I will show you in mine, and then you do yours. You just pour it on top. Are you watching? Can you see? There is pepper on the top. And now while the children pour pepper on their containers, I'm going to explain to you something special. Amen. Now, when you do the pepper, you do it from far and you sprinkle it. Okay?
I don't.
Okay. Now, while the children are putting the pepper into their containers, what we need to do is to have also a toothpick. So you ask mommy to give you a toothpick. If you can't find a toothpick in your house, you go to the garden and get a little stick. And make sure your little stick is really covered with soap. Now, we are going to put some soap in the little stick like this. Oh, it's a bit messy, isn't it? Oh, very messy. Okay. And I give it one each. Don't do nothing. Okay. Now, what happens with the stick? Hurry up. Higher. Okay, the children are still putting pepper. I think they are putting the whole lot of pepper on it. Anyhow, it's all right. You can put pepper. Pepper, remember not to put your nose too close. What happens when the nose is got pepper in it? Children? Yes.
You'll burn and you sneeze.
You will sneeze. Right? So not too much pepper, huh? Okay, Ezra. Done? Are you done, Ezra? Very good. Now what I am doing now, I'm giving a toothpick that has soap. Now, let's say the toothpick is you. What was the container?
The world.
That's what happens when you get pepper on your nose. Yes, now be careful you don't put the pepper on your nose, right? Here you are. Naomi, and one more with all this, and what's happening? Now, what did we say the container was?
The world.
The world, okay. And what are we saying that the toothpick is? Who is it?
Us.
Us, that's right. And let's say that the soap is the glory of God. We have learned before about the glory of God, right? What does the glory of God does? His power? It covers us, right? We are what? In God.
What?
That's right. And we are hidden in God, right? Now, this part of the toothpick is covered with the glory of God. Can you see? Now, did you put soap on your toothpick, on your little stick? Very good. I think we have the pepper sneezes now. Ready? This is us with the glory of God. Now, let's touch only the tip. Touch the top of the pepper and leave it there and see what begins to happen. What's happening? Only on the top, not inside the water. Only on the very top. What's happening? On the very top. Some people have it inside, but it really works when you put it on the top. What's happening? Well, have a look. What happened in yours? What happens is the glory of God separates us from the darkness of this world. Can you see it? Is yours working? Mark, maybe you're putting it too much. Just a little tip. There you go. Very good. Can you see that?
No.
Okay. Let's put a little bit more, let's put a little bit more soap on yours, all right? Because what's happening is it should be just yours working well, Gabby. Now, just on top. Don't put it in the water. Yours is working. Can I have it, Gabrielle? There. Yours work a lot. Okay, let's see what you can do. Just touch with the tip. Just touch. Yes, it is working, Naomi. I can see the separation. That is excellent job. Did you enjoy?
Yes.
Excellent. Did you enjoy that? What does this mean? Now, I need you to give me your toothpicks. Maybe you put them on top of this cloth. Ezra, Naomi, Gabriel, everybody. Thank you, Naomi. Very good. Wow, that was amazing. Isaac, okay. So what happened? You can see in my bowl that the pepper, the moment we touch the world and the darkness of this world with the glory of God in us, what happened to the pepper? What happened to the darkness?
It went away.
So, when God's presence and glory is in us, what happens with the darkness?
It goes away.
Is that exciting?
Yes.
Can I get your attention now? Very good. Can I get all your... You are so good. Now we're going to put all this in here. Very good. You're doing excellently. Now you can do the same thing. You can get rid of all that so we can all have all the attention. Okay. And we are going to read another scripture. And who do you think we should have this time reading the scriptures? Okay, Ezra, you can read the scripture, Psalm 91, verse 1. Are you ready? Have you got a Bible? I reckon that you can go and get your bigger brother or sister, or you can ask your mommy to read the Bible if you cannot read. But if you can, and you got it nearby, You better open in Psalm 91, verse 1, and read together with us.
Lord, you have been our refuge in every generation.
How wonderful. So, what does it say? That God is always with us. Yes, Isaac. The whole way, and always protecting us. Never ever the Lord will allow anything to happen to us except something that will give him his glory. How many of us are willing to do anything, even dangerous things, that will give glory to God?
Never.
Yes, that's right, all of us. So God will never allow anything that will hurt us, except that will teach us to grow more like him. Or it will fulfill his purpose to give him more glory. So when something happens to you, always remember, God is working in you to make you more like him. Now, do you know anything that you might have suffered that make you more like Jesus? Yes? Have you ever experienced injustice at school? Somebody that didn't do the right thing for you because you want to do what's right. Have you? Okay, I'm going to tell you then the story of Mary. Mary was a little girl that was going to school when Grammy was a little girl too. Can you imagine Grammy as a little girl? So, little Mary always wanted to do what was right. But I remember there was one girl called Rafa. And this girl called Rafa was a bit rough, just like the name. And you know, she did something wrong. And guess what? When the teacher found out, she blamed little Mary. But Mary wanted to do the right thing. And even though she said she was not guilty, nobody believed her. But you know what? God was with her. And the girl that did the wrong thing soon enough got caught and got in double trouble. And guess what happened? Little Mary, for being a good girl and always wanting to do what's right, she got the best student award of the week. How about that? So when we do right, sometimes we suffer, but God sees it all and tests if we are going to still be good. So God teaches us, never do evil for evil, but overcome evil with good. Can you repeat that? Can we all repeat that? Never be evil for evil, but overcome evil with good. Are you willing to overcome evil with good? Yes. Always do what's right. God is watching and is ready to give you all a blessing for being good soldiers of the living God. Isn't that exciting? Now, shall we ask the Lord to bless us and help us to always do what's right, even if it's dangerous? Are we ready?
Yes.
Shall we pray?
Yes.
What do we do when we pray? Who didn't answer today? Okay, Gabby.
We close our eyes and we kneel and we put our hands together.
Very good answer. Have you heard that? Hands together. Dear Lord, here are all your little children. Surely they're asking in their hearts, Lord, in these last days, when things get really dangerous, when the world is so covered with darkness, please, Lord, let your glory rest upon all of us, that we with your glory, can touch the world and break all the darkness of the world by the power of your glory. Listen to all the little ones. They are all praying together with me, especially those little ones that are kneeling at home. Some of them, you have called them, Lord, to show your glory upon this earth. Some of them might suffer, Lord, that you be glorified. Would you give them strength and your power? Would you, Lord, anoint them and release your glory upon them, that they may fulfill their destiny and they may walk with God. In Jesus' name, amen. That was a very good prayer, children. I really believe the Lord has heard your prayer and all of your prayers. Now, we are coming close to the end, but there is something we will say all together. Are you going to follow me?
Yes.
Very good. So we say to everyone, remember.
Remember.
Be true.
Be true.
Be kind.
Be kind.
Be generous.
Be generous.
Be peaceful.
Be peaceful.
Be faithful.
Be faithful.
Be courageous.
Be courageous.
Be obedient.
Be obedient.
Believe.
Believe.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Now has come the time to say goodbye to all our little friends.
Bye.
And until we meet you again, God bless you.